Today, we're going to talk about everything that you can change within your course settings. So starting from your homepage, if you look at the course navigation, all the way at the bottom, you have an option called Settings. If you click on that, it's going to take you to a pretty wide range of options of things that you can do here. Actually, I'm going to start over here on the right-hand side on the sidebar and show you just a few things that you can do here. The first thing you can do is you can take all the content of your course and share it to the Commons. And we'll talk more about the Commons in another episode. You can also take a quick look at the student view, and you've already seen that. You can also take a look at your course statistics. This is an empty course that we're looking at right now, so you're gonna see that I don't have anything, but if you wanna see a quick overview of everything that you've got going on in your class this year, this is a great place to look at what you've done and what your students have done. You can also take a look at the course calendar, and that just takes you to the same view that you have from navigating there from the global navigation. You can conclude or delete a course, and I'm going to tell you that I'm going to suggest that you not do this, specifically the delete the course, with anything that is done, any classes that are generated for you by the hub. If you delete a course that the hub created, it can actually mess up syncing for the entire county. So please go ahead and leave this section alone with any hub generated classes. You can copy a whole course over, which just makes a duplicate of all of the course information that you created. And then here's the one I think you're going to find really important. You can import course content. And if you click on this, what it does is it gives you the option to sort of suck all of the content from another course in. So if this summer you're working in a sandbox by yourself or with your CLT to build activities and modules, then you're gonna really like this in the fall because you can open up one of your new empty courses and under content type, you can copy a whole Canvas course, search by name of the course where you've already been building, and then if you choose to import all content, it'll just take all of that stuff that you spent the summer building in your sandbox and pull it all into your empty course that will appear once you have rostered classes in the hub. So I think you're going to find that tool really useful. You also have the option to export course content, and that's something you probably wouldn't do unless you were moving to a different learning management system, like if you were changing school districts. So I would suggest that you kind of ignore that one for now. You can reset course content, which again, you also probably wouldn't want to do because this would take everything that you have in a course and completely erase it. So unless you imported the wrong course content, you probably would not choose to reset your course content. And the last tool on the sidebar shows you how to validate links and content. If you click on that, it gives you a tool called the Link Validator. And what that does is it checks everything in your course, every link in your course, to make sure that it is not a broken link. And if it does, it gives you a full report of every broken link so you can go back and delete it or correct it. We don't want students and parents getting frustrated trying to follow instructions if the links aren't working. So this is something you might want to run maybe once a month just to make sure that everything in your course is going well. Now that we're done with the sidebar, let's also look at the main area. Right here are the course details. You'll find that a lot of this is locked down by Prince William County, so you won't have a lot of options here. But the first fun option you have is that you can choose your cover image for your course. This is visible for you and your students, and this is what shows up on the dashboard. You can upload an image from your computer, or if you go to Unsplash, you can search a bunch of free, royalty-free images that you can use, and they're really lovely. I'm going to search for education, and you'll notice it just brings up pages and pages of images. I like this one, so I'm going to select that. And now that's how this course is going to appear on my dashboard. Most of the other things in here you can't or won't want to change, but I'm going to scroll down to the bottom and point out just some of the most important ones, which are actually hidden here underneath more options. So if I click on more options, there are two things that I really want to make sure that you see here. And the first one is let students self-enroll by sharing with them a secret URL or code. And if you click on that, I'll show you how you can get that code. You wouldn't want to do this with a course that was generated by the hub, but if you had a club or a sport that you wanted students to join, you could. This will create a link for you, which you can send to them via school messenger or email, and that will let them enroll themselves instead of inviting them one at a time. You also have the option right here, and I think you'll definitely want to do this in all of your courses, to check show recent announcements on the course homepage. So when a student logs in, the first thing they'll go to is the homepage. And if you check this button, any announcements that you create will show up right at the top. And you can choose how many announcements. I think 3 is actually probably a really good number. So once you've changed those and taken a look at any of these other settings, you can click Update Course Details. And then this will allow you to scroll back down to the bottom, and it brings you that link that students can use to enroll in your course. Along the top of the course settings, we still have several more options, and I think we're going to look at all of these eventually. This one covers cross-listing, where you can tie courses together, but we won't have information on that until we have our gradebook tied to this. So there's nothing you need to do there now. We looked at navigation. Apps are, we're going to look at in great depth later, and feature options are almost all locked anyway. So ending this video, the last thing that I'd like for you to do today is to go through this main course settings page and make sure that you have, under more options, this button checked so that later when we create announcements, they do appear at the top of your course homepage. Thanks for watching.